Well, the Thrashers have not given their fans much to cheer about tonight. That's the biggest ovation since the Oban goal.
And I thought that some of that action might have happened right after that big hit early in the second, Petrovitsky on Ragnarsson. Bob Hartley thought the same thing because he put that fourth line out there, and Lessard, instead of getting into a fight, drew a penalty. So it all looked good.
Yeah.
They didn't score in the power play. Turnover shortly thereafter, and things changed. And Bob Hartley made his decision. And right side of your screen, this is a private party only, folks. Two guys, and they both throw. There's no in between. One of the best fights I've ever seen in this league, and I've seen a lot of them. Todd Fedoruk and Jeff Odgers. Fedoruk's first year. And Jeff Odgers cut the youngster wide open, and he said, "I just want to thank Mr. Odgers for giving me the chance to go toe-to-toe," because that's the kind of the code of conduct. The old gunslingers don't have to give the young guys a new chance, you know, any life.
Rangers trying to headman. Kovalev was onside. He'll get the puck and get crunched. Radivojevic comes over here to take it away, and here's a fight. Purinton and Fedoruk.
Oh,
Todd Fedoruk in the white, Dale Purinton in the blue, and Fedoruk on top of Purinton. Little old-fashioned Rangers Flyers.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Fedoruk got a big left there at the very end. I think that knocked Dale Purinton down. Fedoruk going 6'2", 235 pounds. Dale Purinton, no slouch, at 6'3", 226 pounds as well. I think Purinton would rather have that kind of penalty than the three minors that send him to the penalty box in last night's game. You take a guy with you, you get the emotions going a little bit.
Brashear tried to stay onside, couldn't corral the pass. Penalty coming up, and here's a fight.
Oh,
and third man in as well. Purinton jumped in, and everybody's in. Only a matter of time.
You see Markkanen looking down towards Sean Burke. Burke's not going anywhere. This wouldn't have happened if Purinton didn't jump in. And Nedved now jumping on top there. Whoa, baby! Got that in for JD. He would love that. I don't see Berkey going anywhere in here. It's a 5-on-5 down low. If it was an odd man situation, then you might see the goaltender come down. If you see Markkanen would jump in to this fray, then Burke would jump in. But that's not happening. That's a pretty tough lineup on the ice here for the Philadelphia Flyers. Todd Fedoruk, Brashear.
Barnaby really tried to keep this going. He got back up and then tried to grab somebody else out of the pile.
Well, might as well get your frustrations out there. See, I give Barnaby full marks. See, he was pushed down originally by Brashear, and that was the minor penalty,
right,
Steve? And, you know, Barnaby could have skated the other way. He's a much smaller player than Dolan Brashear is, but he was going to go right towards Brashear and make sure he had some battle. Brashear's getting a minor penalty for that right there. Good call by the official. Brashear gives him a shove. Nelly Barnaby, we're going to go. Now watch on the right side of your screen. Purinton's going to come in. That's a third man in, and that's the reason why everybody else comes out into this fray. Everybody's going to jump in because Purinton had made it an odd man situation.
Barnaby's trying to prolong this. Purinton is long gone to the Rangers dressing room. He's obviously kicked out for the rest of the game, third man in.
Yeah, and Brashear had already been taken to the penalty box as well.
But this comes as no surprise. Flyers-Rangers, 6-1 game. It was only a matter of time.
Now, this third period could be an hour and 10.
And here in Philadelphia, there won't be anybody going home early despite the score. No problem with this kind of hockey. Piece of Brashear skated the length of the rink to get him.
And he was intercepted by Todd Fedoruk, just like that.
Play allowed to continue on. McDonald and Fedoruk are talking about it in the Flyers' zone.
Well,
and now
well
Brashear
go.
Is paired off with Simon. And the play is still going, and finally the whistle is blown. Down in the Ranger end, Simon falls on top of Brashear. That's a bad break for Brashear. Looks like he tripped backwards on a stick or glove.
Yeah. Well, Todd Fedoruk, I think, was trying to take some of that responsibility off Brashear. Brashear just coming back after having a bad knee. I think he was just saying, you know, Fedoruk was right there when McDonald was trying to get at Brashear, and he just slid in there like the veteran that he is and said, hey, whoa, whoa, I'll take you. You want Brashear, I'll take you.
2:55 left here in the third, and Brashear, somebody on the Ranger bench said something, and Brashear nearly lost it. Might have been Bobby Holik.
Well, Bobby Holik's standing there. Terry O'Reilly, their very tough assistant coach, behind there as well.
Wachinski also had an awful lot to say, it looked like.
Brashear's looking for Holik. You know, the guys would like to have a chance to drop their gloves against big bad Bobby Holik. And Brashear's looking for it. He wants him. Bobby Holik, I think Bobby Holik, in my opinion, of being around the National Hockey League and the way this game and the way the fabric of the game has always been, I think Holik would do himself a favor to look Brashear in the eye and drop his gloves and go him. And I mean, because what happens is everybody else has to do the work then for him.
Yep.
I think he would get more respect around the league. He's respected as a guy that plays the game hard. He's a big, strong guy, and he's a bit of an agitator sort of guy. But in this game, you have to show that you can do it too. And that's the accountability part. And he just doesn't want to be a part of that part of the game. And it's kind of a shame.
Shot. Good check by Lundmark. Ortmeyer comes flying in there. Lacouture taken down by Sharp. Line centering pass for Philadelphia. And here is Fedoruk. Markov and Lundmark. Wow, and Fedoruk, a big hit on Ortmeyer. And a penalty coming up. And Fedoruk went down. Now Solvik's involved. This might be far from over, folks. A minute 9 left in the third, a 6-2 Flyer lead.
Markov and Lundmark have been going at it the whole. Look at it. Markov has taken off his mask, taken off his helmet.
And we do have a fight.
Yep. Sharp,
it's
and Lacouture.
Sharp in the black, Lacouture in the white. Wow, Sharp got a good left in there. And they're going at it pretty good.
Yeah, good scrap right there.
Sharp's got a pair of goals. Are we giving the Gordie Howe hat trick in this one? 2 goals in a fight, does that count?
We'll give it to him. It's been a great effort offensively by Sharp. And I got to tell you something. I give this line of the New York Rangers a lot of credit.
Oh, here we go. Lundmark wants him.
Good for him.
Lundmark and Markov.
Good for Lundmark. He'd been looking like he didn't want a part of it.
Markov just missed with a wild right. Markov on top of Lundmark now. And Kevin Collins will get right in there.
Shows a lot inside the locker room what kind of player you are. And Lundmark deserves a lot of credit as well. This line has been the only line really for the Rangers that has played in straight lines and has played hard. And they've gone through people. Ortmeyer's line with Lundmark and Dan Lacouture.
Hey, happy Valentine's Day, everybody, from Philadelphia.